a very good afternoon. Today is 22nd of May, and thanks to Sunil and Sonali. I know Sonali for several years, and she has given us an opportunity. We run the foundation Freedom from Cancer. It's a public trust for the cancer patients. Nariya patients namak help pannite iruke. Ippo in the COVID pandemic lende we are helping out to the reach of the people with essential grocery kit, that is the Modi kit. Just a small gesture for the society, because now it's the time to give back to the society what we have got. And so Sonali, Sunil, thanks. You also join us over here to distribute the groceries. Thank you.
Ma'am, how do you manage traveling here and there? As COVID, people say it is infection, this, that, stay home.
I keep maintain distance, social distancing. I go for sanitization, gloves, masks. And when I'm in hospital, I'm with the apron and goggles. And we are healthcare workers. If we don't come forward, then how will we address? And it is our time. That's what I told you, to go out and help the needy. But yes, we have to go through the protection things. And that's we have to live with COVID now. Our life is going to be lived with the COVID.
Thank you. Thanks. Many of the people have been sending all these things. They are thinking about the areas that people have really affected. Mm-hmm. But this is a very nice gesture, I would say, because here it's a time for us to think even about the school caretaker, school driver, school watchman, because they are the one who's also taking care of the future kids. So that is the safest place we always say for our children. And I'm sure the children are the, you know, the expensive asset we have. So I really thank Dr. Anita Ramesh for being here and helping all these women who's been working for years for all the little children.
Yeah, thank you, Sonali. And that message is a very important message, because they are the building blocks of our future. And up to 3 years of age is the brain development takes place. And that's the time we should give them real care and give the things that will help them.
This is also a message to all the schools, like even for the parents, that let's take one step forward and make sure that even all the staff who works in the school are really important. They have to be taken care. And when it comes to the teachers, they work hard and they also take care of their dignity. So it's very difficult for them to come forward to ask something. Let us all take a step forward and help them. So I'm really glad for Dr. Anita Ramesh ma'am for doing this. So I have a little one whose mom is not well, but still she has come too.
Thank you very much. Namaskar. Namaste. Namaskar, sir. Inge, na inge thaniya vechirken, ha? Ha? Acha, ninge vaangu. Okay. Idha ninge protein mix powder iruke.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Idha vechukonga, ma. Yes, thank you. Nandri.
Kavin anna.
Nandri. Okay, ninge vaangu.
Ma'am, he has been in our school for past 10 years.
Okay, ma'am.
He's taking
a good job that you are helping and doing so many things. Thank you. In the small word, that's in my gift.
Ma'am, do you have anything to say to all these school people, all these school authorities, also to the parents?
Yes, it's a very good initiative that you have started. And for the children, actually, many of them don't have access to education, and you have made them available in the nook and corner. I was surprised to hear you have 9 branches. So that's something very good, Sonali and Sunil. You're doing a good job. And it is, we should, like an entrepreneur, small places we should start up, and then we all grow together. This is a new innovative idea. And I also suggest all the parents, as soon as the children are 1 year of age, you should send them to some prep school, and maybe up to 3 before they go to higher school. And because up to the age of 3 years is the mental development takes place. So if you are in an
Today we have Dr. Anita Ramesh, who's an oncologist, and she makes sure that patients are back from the cancer with a good health and wealth. But now this is something surprising about her, that she's been helping all the people who are suffering from this COVID, not only at one place but at Kaveri, at Apollo, at Savita, so many places. With that, she's making sure, she's finding out time also to help people in different ways, whether for the needy people, giving away the groceries. Today she has completed more than 400 plus people whom she has given the groceries. So let's have a talk with her and just know how she's able to manage and how come so much of courage she has to do all these things. So ma'am.
Yes, yeah. Thank you, Sonali, for bringing me here. So we run this foundation called Freedom from Cancer. It started in 2010. We initially started with a small group, but then with public demand, it grew over the last 10 years. Now we are a registered public trust. We are ETG certified and we are now going for FCCR registration at this point of time. And it's mainly deals with how to treatment of cancer patients, spreading awareness. We do medical camps, we do cancer meetings, we do public education, we do research, and many other activities within this foundation carries on. It runs, you basically runs by grants, donation, and also we contribute from ourselves to make this a success. Because at some point of time, we need to give something back to the society, and that's how the foundation runs, and we get a lot of support from large amount of people, and that's how it is running so far. Small thing, it doesn't take 30 minutes also to distribute to around 50 people, so we hand it over and then we carry on with work. Okay, I have a team of people working who gets the groceries, everything ready, and then we keep it in our car and we go and distribute it, reach the doorsteps to give it to the people. Because you can't expect people to travel and come to you now. There's right. No conveyance to travel. So that's why we go to the venue and give it up.
Yeah. Right, ma'am. So now what message would you like to give it to the people who have been affected or who feels it's difficult to step out or what needs to be done, or who's a little bit depressed also because of this COVID?
Yeah, this COVID-19 has completely changed the world. It has many things we never expected. It's the biggest pandemic after the Second World War. And as I was telling you, a huge amount of fatality, morbidity, everything you say has happened with this. Economy has gone down drastically. Daily wages and that particular section has suffered a lot. In fact, everybody has suffered. It's not that then. So fear has set into the minds of people, and if you watch the TV news and all, it's even more frightening. So what I would suggest now, we are trying to come out of it. Lockdown has been relaxed. We are in the phase 4 lockdown. Things have started moving. Vehicles and many of the airlines is starting from Monday. Train has started. Many of the shops are open. People are out on the street. They are more relaxed. So slowly we will get back to normal. Economy, being an Indian, economy will pick up faster. That's what I feel, because we are all hard working and we are itself dependent. We can make on our own everything. That's what our Prime Minister told us, and I'm sure, because we at this point of time we manufacture everything, drugs, you see, we never imported anything.
Right.
So we are self-sufficient, so Indian economy will jump back. We have to get back in our shoes and start working, say, from the very day when the lockdown is relaxing. Take things easily. The virus will not go, like I was telling you. You have to live with the virus. You have to live with the virus, and herd immunity is that. So we develop antibodies. Because you are infected, I may get infected, but then our immunity will develop, which will fight against the virus. So that's called herd immunity. So India is now looking at what is called herd immunity. So we fight the virus ourselves, and that's, we carry on, maintain social distancing, maintain sanitization, live with the virus, carry on.
Amazing, ma'am. So that was a nice message that yes, as we are hardworking, and Indian economy will boom back because we are self-dependent. So thank you so much, ma'am, for taking this such an amazing initiative to helping not only the needy. It's not only who's poor is a needy, but also some people are also needy when they need your support, and you have supported all the school staff who's helping the future generation. Thank you so much. Any one message to the world you would like to give?
Stay safe, stay healthy, stay connected.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.